humbled and grateful for his appointment. In a statement, Bautista thanked President Aquino, Defense Secretary Voltaire Gazmin, and outgoing AFP Chief General Jesse De Llosa for their trust in him. He also vows to uphold the mandate of the armed forces. Bautista, a graduate of the Philippine Military Academy, was named Army Chief in 2011. He previously served as commander of the Army's 3rd Infantry Division. The AFP turnover ceremony will be held tomorrow, Thursday. The Commission on Elections disqualifies dozens of individuals eyeing local posts from the midterm for the midterm elections in May. Let's get details from RG Cruz, who joins us from the Commission on Elections. RG?
Hi, TJ. Good afternoon. The Commission on Elections has disqualified some 73 individuals from running for local positions nationwide in the upcoming midterm elections. The Commission on Banks issued Resolution 9610, promulgated on January 11, 2013, that adopts the recommendations of the Law Department and the Provincial Election Supervisors, Regional Election Directors, and Local Election Officers nationwide. The Commonwealth said that they have fact-finding investigations and preliminary hearings of a field official showing, among others, that there are nuisance candidates who have filed their certificates of candidacy to put the election process in mockery and disrepute and cause confusion among the voters by the similarity of the names of the registered candidate and by other circumstances or acts which clearly demonstrate that they have no bona fide intention to run for office for which the certificate of candidacy has been filed. There were 63 names that were declared as nuisance candidates, and their certificates of candidacy were ordered cancelled and their names deleted from the candidate's profile system and the certified list of voters for the May 13, 2013 elections. A good number of these individuals come from Metro Manila and various parts of Luzon and some parts these are mostly from Luzon and from Metro Manila. On the other hand, TJ, there were others, there were 10 others who were declared as ineligible candidates for the positions as part of
DPJ. All right, we're trying to get RG Cruz back on the line. Right now, the NBI is holding a press briefing. Let's listen in.
Halos 42 kasama na yung mga lawyers dito eh.
Sir, yung distribution, ilang AFC na natin?
Ay, hindi ko lang maiano pa.
Kasama-sama na.
Mm. Sir, anong mangyayari doon sa hindi mga umaten, yung mga sinabina?
Kasi hindi ko rin alam kung anong dahilan lang.
Sir, pwede yung sundalo, wala rin sinumit yung affidavit?
So far, wala. Kahit isa ngayon. Sa
kasi
ngayon na wala.
Binabag-interview namin si attorney. Sir, kung
sabi niya meron.
Buwela kanina. Sabi niya meron siya sinumit yung affidavit. General Luga and...
yung other soldiers.
Yeah, abang.
Wala pa. So far, sabi ng mga investigador sa akin, wala pang sinasabi.
So ano lang sila ginawa sa taas?
Siguro, may nag-uusap pa sila doon eh. Hindi pa tapos yung mga pag-uusap nila.
Pero sir, kung hindi pumunta dito yung iba, can you compel them to go pa o NBI?
Kasi kung tutusin, right kasi nila yan kung magbibigay sila ng affidavit o hindi. Pero kasi clear naman yung instruction ni Secretary Rojas na mag-cooperate talaga at sa amin.
So useless sir yung invitation?
So yun, bali...
Hindi pa naman. So hindi ko nga later on, hindi ko alam kung magbabago ang nila, kung magsasubmit sila. Pero so far, sa ngayon, kina-update ko lang kayo na wala pa kaming natatanggap. Hindi ko pa nakausap yung mga investigador namin eh. Kasi alam ko nagpunta na rin sila sa office nila at may mga dokumentong nakuha na rin. So hindi ko pa alam kung ano yung mga dokumento.
Tuloy-tuloy pa ho ang ginagawa yung investigation.
Tuloy-tuloy, andun mga abogado eh. Mga abogado
rin. One time kaya yun?
Wala akong... Hindi ako sure kung anong oras matatapos ito.
Okay, so pero sir, at what point kayo magde-decide na to compel itong mga sundalo, abogado, o mga police?
Yeah, actually, sinapina naman namin sila.
Pero hindi nga pumunta dito pa na
yan. Nasa sa kanila na yun. Basta sinapina namin sila, we will decide siguro kung ano man yung meron kami. Binigay naman, ito namang pagsapina namin sa kanila, pagbibigay sa kanila ng pagkakataon na makapag-sabi na kanilang panig. Hindi ako sure eh. Wala akong kopya ng nung numbers nung sinabihin.
Sir, kung nangungulagan siya na kung sakaling hindi nang mapupunta dito yun, doon na lang tututok sa nakuha mga ebidensya?
Marami naman kami nakuha na rin kahit paano ng ebidensya. Ito okay. Naman eh, pagbibigay nga lang ng pagkakataon sila sa kanila na makapagbigay ng panig nila.
Sir, email na din ba? Yun din ba sinabi niya? Rely na lang on the previous...
No, no. Kay email lang, hindi ko siya nakausap pa.
May sinabi ba siya?
Ay, ano pala. Okay, andito siya. Kung gusto niya, no.
Kumusta ka po?
Okay lang.
Good morning. Director, reaction naman dito sa nangyari? Para sa lahat. Sir.
Well, kanina, no, we were invited or subpoenaed by the NBI to appear before them because of this investigation that's being made, you know, in relation to the Atimonan incident. And so, as a sign of our cooperation dito sa investigation na ginagawa, we allowed ourselves to be present today kasama yung aming mga tauhan na subpoenaed for this purpose. So, this is in deference to the instruction of the President that we have to cooperate in the investigation and to show that we really would want to see the truth in this particular incident.
Were there any affidavits, sir?
Not yet, because as of now, we have yet to see the report of the fact-finding committee, and from there, we can give our response.
Pero sir, reply. But hindi na lang kayo magbigay ng report ninyo bilang response?
The one that was submitted by the PNP.
Pero sir, but wala kayo sa iling report ninyo bilang respondent?
Meron kaming report na, but that report was actually integrated doon sa report na nai-submit namin sa National Headquarters.
What was the content of the report?
Yeah, the way it was. Ano nga po? As submitted by our provincial director and the chief of police.
Sir, pa na rate, sir, for the benefit?
Mahaba yun, ano?
Yeah.
The way it was reported, may nangyaring shootout. The PNP elements were provoked.
Provoked, meaning?
Hinunahan sila sa putok.
Pero,
so,
yun ang report ng tao natin doon, ano? I was not at the crime scene.
Okay.
Even the reporters then were not at the crime scene at the time of the incident. So, I cannot comment kung ano nangyari. Pati kayo rin, wala kayong karapatan na mag-comment.
Yeah.
Diba? Mm. Dahil wala rin kayo sa crime scene. You only can render speculations on this and conjectures. But the thing is, we have an investigation being made. We leave it to the investigators to do their thing and find out the truth of the matter.
Pero sa sinasabing leak, Director, na lumabas sa media?
That is one case of irresponsibility, ano? Kung meron leak report.
Anong report yun?
At yung
sinasabi na yung fact-finding report, ano? If there was a leak, that is, I believe, a case of irresponsibility on those people holding this report that they have.
Sir, kayo ba
yung reaction doon sa pagkakaalis po ninyo sa pwesto bilang
well, I defer to the wisdom of the president at gusto rin natin talaga na maklaro na yung issue, ano? We made ourselves available, our men are there. We can be present anytime that you are called for this investigation.
General Milad, sir, ito ho nangyari, meron ho kayong kinalaman dito, were you the one? Were you aware of what's going to happen?
Did you approve the operation, sir?
Kayo ganito na lang, ano? Ang punta namin dito para sa interview is to say to you that we are cooperating.
Yeah.
Ano? So on the matter of yung case operational plans being approved or ano, we leave it to the NPI to determine yung participation.
Pero, sir,
meron man.
Inaproban niyo ba? Nagsabi ba sa inyo itong grupo ni Colonel Hansel Maranta na meron silang operation sa Atimonan?
Well, as far as I know, I've signed a case operational plan. And the case operational plan was submitted by Superintendent Marantan to the PAOK for its possible funding.
Ayan. So, alam po ng PAOK yung ano yung operation?
Alam.
Inaproban po?
That's for them to answer.
Pero sino sir ang nagbigay ng full authority?
According to them, who said that?
Si Executive Ochoa,
sir. Okay.
And then,
I cannot answer for them, ano?
Yes.
Sila yung mag-ano. Sa level ko, we endorsed it to the PAOCC, as far as I'm concerned. All because, alam mo, yung mga case operational plans would need enough funding, especially kung magandang targets.
Did you receive any centavo from them or what?
That's for Colonel Marantan to answer.
So there was support. In that case,
I said that is for Colonel Marantan to answer.
Superior,
because I believe na siya yung rumekta na upon my approval sa POCC.
Sir,
to ask pero, for the support.
Sir, pero anong laman nung hiningang approval, anong laman nung pre-operational report ni Colonel Marantan?
Again, yung details I cannot disclose. This is a highly confidential matter and it's not supposed to be disclosed.
Ganito na lang, sir. Anong basihan ninyo kung bakit yung in-approve yun?
Siyempre, meron namang mga intelligence targets dun, no? Meron tayong mga targets, criminal elements, doing criminal activities. You know? And especially, during this period of our preparation sa forthcoming elections, we had really been into the possible arrest of criminal elements involved in criminal activities, gun for hire activities, in possession of loose firearms.
Pwede ba yung kahit na hindi approved ang PAOK sa TFP, ma-approvean po ninyo?
The 13 of them, sir.
Kahit na hindi
approved.
Alin?
Merong criminal, merong kayong background records?
Sa akin, ano? Hindi ko alam yung laman completely ng report, yung details. Now, siguro iwan na lang muna natin sa NBI yan, ano? Natingnan kung ano yung laman ng report.
Pero yun
ano?
Yung nasa Copeland case na pinarmahin.
Yes, but I cannot memorize the names of all these people.
Sir, ano? Pero sir, kahit ba hindi aprobado ng PAOK, pwedeng...
I will answer that question as soon as I get the copy of the Copeland.
Sir, pero bakit ano? Special forces yung kinuha para makatulong ng ano? Sinadya Colonel?
Hindi, kasi dito, ano? I signed the Copeland, but I do not exactly know or memorize the contents of the Copeland.
Uh-huh. Sir, do you always do that, General, sir?
Oo nga po, sir. Nabasa ko. Pero hindi ko na-memorize yung ano.
Nabasa
ko, kaya na-inapprove ko. Di ba magandang Copeland yan? Alam mong Copeland is for purposes of funding yan. And in fact, doon sa declaration ng ano, PAOK, ano, the disapproval is only on the portion of the funding of the Copeland. On its operation,
go
pa rin. Di ba nasabi very clearly,
di ba? Operation.
So,
bakit yung special forces yung nakasama?
Yun ang dapat natin malaman, ano? Wala tayo doon sa crime scene, hindi natin mano kung bakit ganun. That's for the NBI to find out.
Hindi kayo, to investigation. Hindi kayo, sir, ayun na inform about yung kung sino yung push your demand.
Ano na lang, ano? Lahat ng tanong nyo, masasagot namin sa NBI yan. Of course, hindi naman kayo investigating body. Ito, for purposes of maybe putting some clarity, you know, sa issue. But on the details, on the specifics, pwede ba iwan na lang natin sa NBI?
General, kayo rin ba nag-approve ng shootout sa San Juan, Batangas? Pati isa ka lang ba?
I do not approve yung shootout.
Yung operation.
Hindi ko alam yung ano. Hindi maganda yung ano. So I think that's enough. Okay na. Thank you.
That was the Calabarzon Regional Director, PNP Chief Superintendent James Melad, who was yesterday relieved from his post. He says that he submitted himself to the NBI to show that he and other police officers who were involved in the police operation in Quezon are cooperating with the National Bureau of Investigation as directed by the President and by the ILG Secretary Mar Rojas. He criticized a report that came out in a newspaper that said the fact-finding team of the PNP had found that the Quezon incident was not a shootout but an ambush. He also said this report was irresponsible and unfair. Melad also stood by his decision to approve the Quezon operation at his level. He did say that the PAOK, the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission, knew about this operation, but he did not want to answer questions as to whether or not it was approved. He did say that he is standing by his decision to approve.